I'm Meg from Professional Music Technology, and in this video I will be taking a look at 5 of the best Parlour guitars for under £500. With an ever-growing demand for smaller acoustics, whether it's for travelling, for kids, or even just to have a convenient acoustic next to the sofa to pick up whilst you're watching Netflix, Parlour guitars have been a growing popular choice. If you aren't too familiar with what a parlor guitar is, these are one of the oldest acoustics coming to fruition in the late 1800s, and one of the first guitars to be made widely popular with steel strings instead of nylon strings. They were predominantly used by musicians for performances in smaller venues such as bars or parlors, hence the name. They tend to have a slightly shorter scale length than a standard acoustic, and they have a recognizable elongated body shape, which makes them distinguishable from your classic dreadnought or concert size. So I'm not repeating myself too much throughout the video, I will mention now that the necks on most parlor guitars do tend to join at the 12th fret, and this will be a common theme across the guitars we'll be taking a look at. It's also worth mentioning that because of the smaller body, they do tend to have a slightly higher tone with more mid-range than bass. This does make these guitars particularly popular for folk, blues and roots guitarists due to the twangy tone. So, first up on our list today is a staple parlor guitar and one of our most popular models, the Gretsch G9500 Jim Dandy. This particular guitar has been around for a fair few years now, and due to its playability, affordable price point and ideal smaller size, it's a go-to choice for anyone looking for a travel guitar, a guitar to learn on, or a smaller bodied acoustic for kids. A homage to the Gretsch Rex parlor guitars in the 1930s, 40s and 50s, it has a real authentic look and sound. So to go over the specs quickly, this is a parlor size guitar with a 24-inch scale length. It has a laminate basswood top with basswood back and sides. Basswood is a very light wood and easily accessible, so is often used by brands like Gretsch as a great option for budget-friendly instruments. It offers a great mid-range while still keeping a warm tone even on the smaller bodied guitars. The X bracing used inside helps to give the smaller body extra resonance. And as I mentioned, this guitar joins at the 12th fret. It also has a super comfortable C-shaped NATO neck with a walnut fingerboard, easily playable for any beginners. Up on the headstock, it has a set of high-quality 1950s-style open-gear die-cast chrome tuners. As well as that, it has a walnut top-loaded bridge and a compensated saddle, single-ply pickguard with the signature G logo, and it's available in this authentic-looking two-tone sunburst finish. Overall, a fantastic and budget-friendly choice for anyone looking for a great-sounding and looking parlor guitar. Moving on, the next guitar we'll be taking a look at is the Tanglewood Java TWJP. Whilst this guitar has some similar specs to the Gretsch we've just taken a look at, the woods used on this particular model is what makes it stand out so much from the others. From the top, this guitar looks just like your standard spruce top parlor, but on the back it has a really unique wood split construction, making this one of my favorite parlor guitars we'll be looking at today. So to run over the specs, this is a parlor sized acoustic with a 25.5-inch scale length. It has a solid spruce top with a laminate Amara back and sides with a split of spalt mango running through the middle of it, giving it not just a really distinctive look, but the spruce and Amara, which is a type of ebony, offers a very bright and balanced tone. Perfect for any fingerstyle players or someone looking for an overall bright and well-balanced sound for something like bottleneck slide. It has a very comfortable NATO neck with a Techwood fretboard, and just like the Gretsch, the neck also joins at the 12th fret. Up on the slotted headstock, it has a set of open back nickel vintage tuners, which gives this a really classic vintage look. This particular guitar is just acoustic, but these guitars are also available as an electroacoustic, fitted with a Fishman Precis pickup with onboard EQ controls and a built-in tuner. And lastly, the simple design is topped off with a high gloss finish, giving it extra protection against the elements and an overall very sleek and classy design. A distinctive guitar with some really unique features. Next up on my list of Parlour guitars worth looking at is the Epiphone L00. This model is a direct descendant of Epiphone's original line of flat-top Parlour guitars in the 1930s, keeping that same look and style but with some more modern additions, including built-in electronics, so this guitar would also make a great option for gigging musicians. So, looking over the specs, this guitar has a solid spruce top with laminate mahogany back and sides. If you aren't too familiar with laminate woods, then this is a process used commonly across budget-friendly guitar makers as a way to keep construction costs down, but still keeping that great tone and quality. It consists of thinly layering veneers of wood instead of using a solid piece of that wood. This is, of course, a much more affordable method and makes these guitars a lot more resilient against different climate and humidity changes. The tone of the spruce and mahogany pairing gives this guitar a very top-heavy but still quite warm sound, perfect for folk and blues styles, but not limited to these particular genres. It has a mahogany neck with an Indian laurel fretboard and a slim tapered D neck profile for easy playability. Up on the Epiphone 60s Dove Wing headstock, it has a set of high quality Grover Rotomatic tuning heads. It also features an imitation tortoise shell pickguard for a real authentic vintage look. And lastly, this guitar comes fitted with a Fishman Sonicore pickup, making this guitar an ideal choice for live shows. The pickup has a tone and volume control located just inside the sound hole, giving you the flexibility of shaping your acoustic sound on stage. So in conclusion, this guitar would be a great choice for anyone looking for a balanced sounding and authentic looking parlor guitar. I'll be taking a look at today is the Faith Naked Mercury. If you haven't heard of the brand Faith, then they are definitely worth getting familiar with. An excellent range of guitars designed by British luthier Patrick James Eggle, originally known for his range of high quality and unique electric guitars. Faith guitars have a few features which make them stand out from the other guitars at the same price point, which I will go through today. So taking a look at this particular model, the Faith Naked Mercury is a traditional style parlor guitar, and just like the others mentioned, the neck joins at the 12th fret. However, unlike the others I've mentioned, this guitar is made from 100% solid wood. It has a solid spruce top with a solid mahogany back and sides. This classic acoustic guitar wood pairing allows for well projected bright tones with plenty of harmonic overtones. For the size of the body, the solid wood also really helps this guitar to resonate with a surprisingly big sound. It has a super comfortable mahogany neck with an Indonesian ebony fretboard and bridge. It also has a Patrick James Eagle bolt-on neck design. Up on the headstock, there is a set of high-quality Faith Precision Chrome tuning heads. And to keep the overall cost of construction down, this guitar features a very simple design and a smooth satin finish. I think this gives it a very sleek overall look. And lastly, this guitar comes with a high-quality padded Faith gig bag, making it easy to transport if you are going to a guitar lesson, to school, or to a live show. Lastly, the final guitar I'll be mentioning is one I've touched on briefly in previous videos and one of my favourite models in store at the moment, the PRS Tonare P20. These are not just great looking guitars, but great sounding models too. This particular model I'll be looking at today is the vintage mahogany finish, but they are also available in a few other finishes, including a limited edition Lotus Pink, which you can check out more information about over on PMTV UK. To run over the specs of these models quickly, unlike the others we mentioned, this is a parlor guitar which joins at the 14th fret, which is actually the same as the Epiphone, and this gives you easier access to some of these higher frets. It has a solid mahogany top with a laminate mahogany back and sides. The all mahogany gives this guitar more of an organic and warm voice than some of the spruce top models of the same size. It features PRS's wide fat neck radius, giving it a really playable and comfortable feel, particularly for anyone with smaller hands or just looking for something a bit more comfortable to play. It has an ebony fretboard and bridge with that signature PRS bird design running down the fretboard. On the headstock, it has a set of high quality vintage style butterbean tuning heads. They really help to give this guitar a rustic and vintage look. And finally, it also comes provided with a great quality PRS padded gig bag for easy transportability. An excellent choice for anyone looking for a unique looking and sounding parlor guitar. So that was a quick look at five of the best parlor guitars we stock here at PMT. If you want to find out any more information about any of the guitars I've mentioned in this video, then head over to our website, pmtonline.co.uk, or you can pop down to your local professional music technology store and have a chat with one of our acoustic experts. The mic we've been using on the guitars in this video is the Lewitt LCT 440 Pure. You can also find out more information about this over on our website. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more content like this one. Head over to our socials at PMT House of Rock and give us a follow. I will catch you in the next video.